On April 8th this year, we're gonna have an eclipse here in Russellville.
It's a gift given to Russellville.
Russellville is on the map now nationwide.
This is the largest event Russellville has ever seen.
Don't sleep on this.
That amount of people has never came here for anything.
This is a once in a lifetime event for all of us.
It's like my Bible moment. It's like when Moses became Moses.
I guess it's a pretty big deal.
4 minutes and 11 seconds has got us all this popularity.
Our official tourism shirt says, I got mooned in Russellville. And we were like, oh boy.
We definitely got mooned in Russellville.
We are the best place to come and view the 2024 eclipse.
Russellville is a pretty neat place to live.
I love Russellville.
Russellville's a beautiful place.
It's a great natural place for adventure.
We have mountains.
The lakes and the rivers and the valleys.
World-class mountain bike trails.
That's it. Those are the things to do.
No.
I'm just kidding.
I reckon we've got a little of everything.
It's a small town, but big town and a big heart.
It's just real. I'm the executive director of tourism.
I'm vice president and chief clinical officer with Arkansas Hospice.
I'm an artist.
¿Qué tal, amigos? Les habla Obi de Eleva Russellville.
We do local podcasts and we highlight the community. I do the Spanish version of it.
At the crack house, I sell seafood, burgers, wings, soul food, whatever you want.
And I do what anything anybody needs. So we do anything from snow cones to real estate.
I own Dog Ear Books and Retro Roast, and I'm on city council. People kept saying, you should run for something. And I was like, first of all, I don't run. I had so many votes, I could have almost been mayor. But Fred's good too right now.
I'm mayor of Russellville, Arkansas.
Cut hair. Trim beards.
She needed a friend to help her.
I'm excited for the eclipse.
I was born in 32, but I can't think of anything any greater than this eclipse. But the most exciting thing to me was when I used to, we picked cotton and I used to ride in a wagon.
Are you excited for the eclipse? Or
There's moments. There's definitely moments. We've been preparing for almost 2 years. As the tourism director, it's a little nerve-wracking. The closer it gets, I have moments where there's like lots of anxiety. Are we making sure everything is done and prepared? It's night and day. My phone is with me all the time.
I was still on the Main Street board when they first started talking about it. And I was like most people, okay, there's gonna be an eclipse. We've had some before, you know? And they're like, no, 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 you don't understand. Like, people won't be able to drive on the interstate. There's gonna be porta potties on the interstate.
We have over 200 porta potties rented just to be in our community.
Could we have 30,000 people show up, or could we have 150,000 people show up? We just genuinely don't know.
Considering our town is around 30,000 people, that's a whole lot of visitors.
People are saying millions are showing up, and it's like, well, yeah.
We're anticipating people from 40 plus states and a dozen different countries.
This is gonna be a big opportunity.
We're just both trying to figure out how much we need to stock up, because I'm pretty sure we'll be running out of food.
It's like we're prepping for a snowstorm.
I will be ready for as many people as that we can possibly fit in our town. Getting supplies already dialed in.
We also want to be very sure that they have plenty of medications to last throughout that time, because we won't be able to get back and forth to pharmacies.
The economic impact of this is huge for our community.
This could make a business.
Try to monopolize your business. Make money.
It's just about being creative.
It's gonna be a lot of snow cones.
I'm excited about the eclipse. Yeah. We'll be open, we'll be taking walk-ins.
We're gonna have an eclipse drink at the coffee shop and
cool glasses.
Oh, yeah, and the cool glasses that me and another designer, that's pretty cool, did. We're about to get a whole bunch of books in that have to do with the eclipse.
I'm planning on having a comedy show so you could crack up and eat the crack house.
I hope I'll get some extra haircuts in here during that eclipse.
We'll take a little 4-minute break. It's okay.
We expect a full sellout. The Holiday Inn Express were like $999.
People that are spending so much money to come here for 4 minutes, I mean, that's just unreal to me.
I know a lot of people that are just leaving. They just don't want to be around the craziness.
I'm renting my house out.
I thought about renting my home out and sleeping in the barn, but my wife would frown on that.
It's a mixture of emotions around town.
Never having this many people in our area.
Public safety is the number one thing.
Some people hear fearful things.
They've been saying that the power grid isn't enough to support it.
I've heard chatter about the cell phone gonna be slow.
The gas station's running out of gas.
So we are trying to downplay that and just tell them that as a community, we're really prepared.
Our biggest challenge we expect to be the traffic congestion.
Is there going to be gridlock?
I don't see how they're going to fit that many people on these little roads.
There will be spaces specifically for emergency personnel. We'll have like golf carts to take people to their jobs.
We'll have extra manpower as far as police department, fire department, EMS.
If the systems go down, we're going to cash only.
Well, it is a happy disaster.
It's going to be out of this world.
It's going to be stellar.
It's kind of weird, like the quietness and that the animals, the night animals can come out, and just there's this kind of this quiet awe maybe.
It's a reminder of how small we are on this big, vast earth.
You'll take your little wand and the eclipse will come.
The sun's just gone in the middle of the day. That's weird.
It'd be like a spiritual experience.
You'll see a 70-year-old person go, I've never been impacted like that in my life.
I probably won't watch it.
Whether it's cloudy or not, we're going to have a great time.
I think anyone who's worked in hospice any length of time, I think we learn to not take much for granted.
I think the poor mayor needs a very long nap after this all happens.
We will all breathe a sigh of relief on April 9th.
I am so ready for April 9th.
If this ever happens again, which maybe it probably will in 100 million years.
2045, there is an actual longer eclipse coming.
We'll just be ready.
I don't think I will be mayor in 21 years.
I'll probably be mayor by then.
You'd be so cute, little old lady with that cap on backwards.
Life is for us to enjoy, and we only have so many minutes we get to do that.